That sentiment is echoed today by the
honor the memory of those killed today by having the courage to write and draw of whatever political or religious debate they want. Justice, news, Montreal. In other news, there's a growing debate over whether the names of 13 Dalhousie dentistry students should be made public. They've been suspended by the Halifax University for posting sexist and misogynistic comments. School has refrained from releasing the names, as are most media outlets, including the CBC. But the online activist group Anonymous says they will make the names public. Stephen Buttigieg has a story.
The names of all the team members of the general club will be released.
The group Anonymous's YouTube post threatening to publish the names of the 13 suspended fourth-year dentistry students from Dalhousie University in Halifax. It had originally said it would be done Monday, but still no names today. The university won't post the names, at least not yet, nor will the CBC. CBC says it doesn't know who did what and doesn't want to influence the investigation. Wayne McKay is a law professor at Dalhousie University. He says that is a wise decision at this point in the investigation.
There hasn't been a process yet. There hasn't been real findings of who did what and those kinds of things. So it seems to me to release those names as a group of 13 at this point, at a minimum, is premature.
Meanwhile, the group Anonymous has released a new video today asking for the public's help in verifying evidence before it takes any action. Stephen Buttigieg, CBC News, Halifax.
The federal government has pledged to resettle 10,000 refugees from Syria in Canada over the next 3 years. Ottawa had earlier promised to take in 1,300 Syrians by the end of 2014, but the true number who have been allowed in has been hard to pin down. The federal government is also boosting its commitment to resettle Iraqi refugees, taking in an additional 3,000 by the end of this year, on top of the 20,000 that are already here. That's the CBC News to this hour. I'm Dwight Smith.